Genesis 12, through you, right? So so this is also repeated in, 22? And every time there's a child born, God, because he doesn't force you to be in covenant with him, he asks you, you want to be in covenant with me? Yeah, I want to be in covenant with you. All right. So you have to redo the covenant constantly. You find this with Abraham, then you find it with Isaac, then you find it with Jacob, then you find it with the tribes of Israel. They're reinitiating the covenant. God's reaching out saying, we're good together. We're going to do this. Okay, good. So sign on the dotted line here. And we're moving forward. So the rabbis acknowledge something pretty interesting with regard to the grafting in. Through you, all the nations will be blessed, through Abraham, right? So Genesis 14, 15, and then you repeat with, Isaac in 22, I believe it is, and so on and so forth. You find this repeating that through you, all the nations will be blessed, or ve'nivarechu. And that essentially means, at least in the Mishnaic form of Hebrew, which is very similar to Hebrew, okay? This Mishnaic form of Hebrew, the rabbis see, hold on, this intermingling, this grafting, this is what the word blessed really means here. Through you, Abraham, all the nations of the world will be grafted in. That's what the rabbis say that passage means. This is not Christian interpretation, although we agree with it. Yes, we agree. Bravo, Rabbi, you figured it out. But you figured it out by just knowing what the Hebrew word meant and knowing how it is used in the scriptures. Okay, it's this blessing. Well, what better way to bless the world than to graft them into you? Which is why in the New Testament, you find such a heavy focus on the fact that through you, you're Abraham's seed. You believe in Christ, you're Christ's seed. That's in Isaiah 53, that he's going to see his offspring. That's Galatians 3, guys. You are the spiritual seed of Abraham, which is ultimately a spiritual seed of Christ.
There you go. Yeah, Galatians 3:16, Abraham's seed, singular, was the promise made. Again, it's mm-hmm. one seed, because I think a lot of time Israel says it's all of us, all of Israel. But mm-hmm. something Paul points out is that seed, as in one single person, mm-hmm. the whole world would be blessed. So another good point.